This is the introduction to the Creative Release Meditation. The meditation is designed to help free your natural creativity so that you can do whatever you set out to do with your best chance of success. You can use it to help you achieve any result or outcome. The meditation applies to general and specific, diffuse and concrete, unknown and known outcomes. You can even use the meditation to decide what goals or objectives to set when you do not know what you want or what would be best. The meditation is designed to help you to realize more easily any state of affairs that does not yet exist. So you can use it for many different purposes. This is most important, so I will repeat it. When you specify something that you want to achieve, whatever it is, the meditation is likely to help you achieve it. It really does not matter what the goal is, this approach can help. The goals can be purely personal. They may involve you with others in some way, or they may be non-personal and only involve physical conditions or events. We all have great creative powers that we can mobilize to make life full and easy. The meditation helps to do this and helps us to use our creativity to best advantage. It does this in two crucial ways. First, the meditation enables us to define our goals or objectives in a manner that maximizes our chances of success. Second, the meditation enables us to become one-pointed. This enables us to apply all our energies in the most unified and effective way we can. In the process of doing this, we ensure that everything in us is balanced and integrated with our goals. At this point, I will spend a little time looking at goals. We need to describe them clearly so that we have a chance of achieving them easily. I will then describe how to become one-pointed. The first thing is to be clear about what a goal is. A goal is any target or objective. It is anything that we set out to do or achieve that we have not yet done or achieved. For example, finding a job, having a shower tomorrow morning, being happy, passing an exam, or planting some flowers. Now, while goals are things that have not yet been realized, I suggest that you think about them differently. I suggest that you think of any goal in terms of the state of affairs that will exist as the goal is realized. This will help ensure that you have a complete picture or idea of your goals. You think of what is and of what is happening when the goal is completed. Just imagine what will be happening at the end if everything works out completely. For example, you do not think of finding a job, you think of actually having the job. You do not think of having a shower the next morning, you think of what it will be like after having had the shower the next morning. You imagine yourself as already happy. You imagine what will be happening after you have passed your exam. And you imagine that you have already planted the flowers and you think of what that will be like. You may be wondering what value there is in this approach. Well, this is the way I understand it. As human beings, we tend to get what we expect in life. Where we start is where we finish, unless we change our goals. And what we concentrate on is what we get. If we expect to succeed, then generally we do. If we expect to fail, then generally we will do that too. When we plan or expect to complete something by a certain time, then generally we do. When we do not expect to get something finished in that time, then generally we do not. You can check most areas of your life. See whether this is true. Be sure as you check that you understand that sometimes we have mixed reactions. On the surface, we may really want something or really expect that what we want will occur. However, as well as that, or underneath that, we also expect trouble or have doubts. Both aspects of our reactions contribute to the outcome. You also can notice from now on how this works in your life. Notice how much your expectations about achieving your goals are generally fulfilled. What you do imagine you will achieve is generally what you do achieve. So I am suggesting that what you expect to achieve is likely to come true. How you expect to achieve it is also influenced by the same principles. Take some examples. If you imagine, think, or feel that something will be easy, then generally it turns out that way. If you imagine, think, or feel that it will be difficult, then generally it turns out that way. If you imagine that something will take a long time, but that you will get there in the end, then generally this is what will unfold. If you imagine that something can only arise through the intervention of others, then generally you will only get it if others intervene. Again, you can examine your life and consider how you approached getting the things that you now have in your life. I think that you will find that there is a direct relationship between the two. So to summarize what I have said so far, we get the best results with goals by imagining that they are already accomplished and that they were accomplished very easily. Remember, the principle is, where we start is where we finish, unless we change our goals. By starting in fantasy in the position in which we want to be at the end, then we end in that position. The meditation gives you a means of checking this for yourself and a way of becoming increasingly accomplished at living your life in this manner. Now, there are three further hints I have in relation to setting your goals. The first is to put things in terms of what you want, not in terms of what you do not want. So when you picture or describe your goals, do so in terms of what will exist. Consider these examples. If your goal is to weigh less, specify the goal in terms of a particular weight, 65 kilograms, say, rather than in terms of losing weight. If you want to stop having conflict with someone, specify the goal in terms of what you want. For example, harmony, peace, mutual respect, cooperation, or sharing. The second hint is to use the present tense in the way you express, picture, or feel your goals internally. The present tense brings them into the present. The future tense keeps their realization in the future. To illustrate the value of this, consider the following three goal statements: to wash the dishes, to have a holiday, and to be a touch typist. Notice a way a restatement can lead to a very different response to the goal. Consider, the dishes are already washed, dried and put away. The holiday is over and was a great success for all concerned. And I am a touch typist who types at 130 words per minute. The third hint is to do with mobilizing our power through expressing, picturing, or feeling our goals in a special way. I recommend that you use what are called I am affirmations. I am affirmations enable us to release and harness the vast power available within us. The more power we release in our creativity, the easier it is to achieve our objectives. For general empowering of you and your goal, you can affirm, I am the perfect outcome in this situation. I am the completion of this goal. Or, I am the perfect outcome here. If you want to be specific, you do this very simply. You affirm, I am, and then add whatever you want to be true. For example, a computer expert, a calm person, a wealthy person living an abundant life, or a completely healthy and happy person. The power of fundamental creativity does the rest. Now, putting these three hints together, what is the result? When setting your goals, I have recommended that you do so first in terms of what you want, second, in terms that think of and describe them in the present, and third, that you use I am affirmations to express, picture, or feel their truth internally. Now, one further overall comment. With your goals, always reach for the stars. Many people have found that the more they include in their goals, the more they achieve. The second aspect of the meditation will help you balance your hopes and ideals with practicalities if you need this. This brings me to the second major aspect of the meditation. I mentioned it at the beginning. We need to make sure that we are one-pointed. One-pointedness about our goals is just as important as defining them clearly and effectively. One-pointedness ensures that our whole systems, our bodies, feelings, thoughts and behaviour all act in accord with our goals. You use the meditation to become one with your goals, thereby ensuring that you are completely aligned and integrated in relation to them. This will mobilise within you all that can contribute to achieving your objectives. At the same time, the same process will help you release all inner obstacles or impediments to achieving your objectives. The way we become one-pointed is through a process called grounding. Grounding enables us to integrate ourselves with our goals so that we are completely at one with the goals we set ourselves. Grounding will enable you to mix completely your goal definitions and commitments with the rest of your system, so that your system is completely aligned with them. I will describe some of the ways this works in a few moments. Before doing so, however, I want to mention some of the general benefits of grounding. Groundedness is a natural part of being alive. Everyone is always grounded to some extent. When well grounded, we pay attention both to the physical sensations and experiences we are having on the inside of our bodies and to the physical things and events around us. That is, when grounded, we always remain aware at some level of the physical aspect of what is happening on the inside and outside of our bodies. This is a wonderfully easy way to stay in balance and equilibrium, or if we are not experiencing them, to establish balance and equilibrium. Groundedness produces beautiful results and produces them very quickly. When well grounded, ease, harmony, light and fragrance automatically intensify and expand throughout our systems, while discomforts, disharmonies, dullness and unpleasantness automatically dissolve and disappear. Well-grounded people experience the naturalness of life more often and more easily than poorly grounded people. Many have discovered this. Well-grounded people also remain poised and balanced most of the time. They develop a great capacity to establish and re-establish inner balance, ease, fullness, security and health. There are natural processes in us that take care of imbalances, discomforts, and groundedness is the key to releasing these natural processes to take care of things quickly and completely. These natural processes operate amazingly quickly, deeply, and fully, and they are automatic. They occur without thought or action. Groundedness stimulates and enhances these natural processes so that they will operate fully. As you do the meditation, you can reap these general rewards from the grounding parts of it. The way grounding is specifically helpful in the meditation is to do with the way it produces balance in our systems. When we hold a goal or objective in our awareness, our systems are activated by that. A series of thoughts, feelings, fantasies, pictures, inner dialogues, or expectations are stimulated. These responses arise both out of those aspects of us that are supporting the goals and out of those that are not or may not support it. If left stirred up, all these reactions keep influencing the outcome. By grounding ourselves as we consider our goals, our systems are enabled to reach a new balance and equilibrium in relation to the goals. And this works very well. We can become free, open, harmonious, and clear internally as we consider our goals or while we do what is necessary to achieve them. Inner support for our objectives usually strengthens. Inner opposition or obstacles usually melt away. In addition, by using grounding as we consider our goals, there are three general types of responses people have. First, we can become committed to and certain of our success. Second, we can change our goals. Third, we can combine these two. That is, we can both change our goals and we can become committed to new outcomes and certain of our success with these. Convictions of success and our commitment to success arise out of the way the goal setting and the grounding steps in the meditation combine. Their combination activates our strength, will and creativity for achieving our goals. This is to do with conceiving the goals or objectives as already accomplished. Commitment to success is a natural outcome of this. Awareness of the value of changing our goals also arises out of the way the goal setting and grounding processes combine in the meditation. Such changes seem to occur naturally and easily and arise from at least two influences. The first is to do with releasing unfinished business. As we affirm our goals and stay grounded, old inhibitions related to achieving the goals are stimulated and then released. As the release occurs, we can find that our perception of the value of the goals can change, particularly if the goals were generated either within or in relation to those inhibitions. Also, commonly, when freed from old inhibitions, we no longer experience some of our goals as relevant, valuable, or desirable. For example, if someone is not convinced of his capacity to do something, he may never set goals that include this thing. To illustrate, a man does not feel secure about meeting people and so never thinks of doing anything that takes him into contact with strangers, except by accident. After using the meditation, he can find that he now knows that he can do what he previously thought he could not do. So he begins to think of a whole range of goals that once he automatically would not consider. He decides that he can go out socially, meet and talk to people at work, and travel. The second influence that the grounding steps have on change in our goals is very significant too. The grounding steps enable us to dream with our feet on the ground. The process itself automatically enables us to reach for the stars, as I recommended before, at the same time as tempering our hopes and dreams with current reality. The here and now alertness and awareness that grounding stimulates tends to produce common sense perceptions and understanding. We tend to notice any practical need for change and notice the nature of the needed changes. They tend to become obvious to us quite spontaneously. Throughout the meditation, I will give you instructions on when and how to do the grounding. These instructions will be sufficient for you to do the meditation. If, in addition, you decide that you would like to concentrate more completely on grounding, then you can contact the Guild and obtain the grounding meditation. This meditation enables you to practice grounding alone and enables you to experience and identify the specific benefits of the process. Now, I am almost at the end of this introduction. You now have a description of the various aspects of the meditation and may be enthusiastic to do it. When you do, you are likely to find that a question arises. How will I know that the meditation is helping? First, you will know that the process is helping as your goal setting becomes easier. Whenever you consider your goal, the easier it is for you to imagine that it has already happened, the closer you are to success. Second, when you are certain of success, having previously been uncertain, you will know that the meditation is helping. You need to feel this confidence, and the meditation is designed to help you do so. Third, the ultimate signal that it is helping is obvious. You will have succeeded. Your goal will be an established reality. One last thing, and this is very important. At the end of the meditation, it is important each time to do something concrete or specific, to take action. You make what you do consistent with your goal already being a realized reality. It does not matter how significant this act is, doing something is important. Of course, in what you decide to do, take account of the likely consequences. You also do something, again, no matter how small, that helps produce the result you want to be an established fact. Our goals tend to be achieved much more easily when we do our part in producing them. So, no matter how small a contribution it may seem to you to be, do something that will contribute to your goal becoming an established reality. So there it is. The meditation is basically very simple and easy to understand. As you set your goals, you imagine that they are already achieved, that they are an accomplished fact. You set them in terms of what you want. You set them as if anything is possible. And you use I am affirmations to express, picture, or feel their truth internally. At every step of the way, you concentrate on grounding. Then, at the end of the meditation, you do something concrete and explicit that expresses your success. And you do something to promote your success. During the meditation, I will give you instructions that will take you one simple step at a time through this whole process. It is wonderfully simple and increasingly rewarding the more you practice it. Now, if you are ready to do the meditation using the detailed instructions, go ahead and do so. If you want to listen again to this introduction, simply start at the beginning again.